prefers Fuffle Cloud playing a Dusty Revenge.
This is where it all began. The night where they took everything from me. I rushed back into the burning house, but it was already too late. Everything was engulfed in flames. I made my way in, only to find Daisy lying motionless on the ground. I struggled to make sense of what happened. Why would anyone do this to Daisy? I carried the weight of Daisy in my arms and struggled out to the field, to safety. But that would be the last time I held her. Anguish and sorrow filled my heart. And then I saw them. Beneath the sooty haze walked three of them. They trotted towards the woods. They had taken something else from me. An artifact that my father had given me on the night he left for good. But why? I was confused and lost. But most of all, hatred clouded my mind. It wasn't long before everything went black. My life as I knew it ended then and there. But I live for something else now. I'll seek my revenge, and those murderers shall live in hell.
Okay. So that's a start. Those loading screens. Okay, yeah. More loading.
I'll have my revenge.
Okay, so let's see. Okay. He has really weird ears. You know, that's a rabbit. Oh, framing drops.
No matter where you hide.
Okay, so far it's like button mashing. Turn over to the block one. Thank you. I gotta grab something.
Getting closer. To get to the bottom of Daisy's death, I went searching for the famed prophet Gladius.
Gladius?
I found her inside the tavern, with her wares spread out on the round tabletop. She was old. Older than I had imagined. Her eyes met mine, but before I could speak, she asked if I was the son of Dante. It seems she had been waiting for me all this while. But I didn't seek her for all that, and patience was never a virtue of mine. I demanded her to look into the crystal ball of hers, to find me the men behind that murderous knight. Instead, she mentioned that my destiny was hung over her neck, and proceeded to remove her neck piece. It was akin to a compass, and it had glittered and blinked profusely in front of my eyes. The old lady explained that the compass and my destiny were woven together. She was about to elaborate, but she never got the chance. Someone had taken her life. Someone familiar.
First
the face
spot.
That I had seen from that fateful night. The face I couldn't forget. I was glad he found me before I found him. It was obvious he didn't want Gladius talking to me. Something tells me I was on the right path.
Poor kitty.
For revenge was ever so slightly quenched by the sight of Reto lying on the ground, his face covered in blood. In a plea for me to spare his life, he began offering me a name, Kraven. I've heard that name before. Kraven was an enigmatic and powerful warlord, feared by all. It was then I realized that Reto was simply a pawn. Kraven was the mastermind behind it all, the cause of Daisy's death. Through the corner of my eye, I saw Reto standing up, ready to ambush me. But that wasn't gonna happen. As Rondel appeared in the nick of time, a cannon taller than himself, he took Reto out. For saving my life, he asked that I seek out Kraven with him. Rondel was a complete stranger up until that night. But I soon realized that both of us shared a similar predicament. Apparently, Rondel's son was bound to an ancient artifact, and Kraven was holding him captive. It was too much of a coincidence that all this had happened on the same night. I knew there was going to be more to this.
Oh, I didn't get the other two. Or any of those. Well, that's what I'm going to do for on that part. Let me know if you all want me to continue on with this. All the furries have a fantastic day. Bye.